such an honor having you here.
Thank you.
Last time I saw you, 2 years ago at the Super Bowl, I hosted the NFL Honors, and you were there. That was the night you found out you were going to be inducted in the Hall of Fame.
Yes, yes.
And here was a photo. We ran into each other, and I was very happy to get that. Although I'm very upset because I realized I was wearing a free giveaway hat instead of the Patriots logo up there, and now I realize I shouldn't have been wearing that with you. But the thing about that night, and what a great part of the NFL Honors for me, and I think for people watching it, but maybe stressful for people like you, is you find out right before the show if you have made the Hall of Fame induction class.
Yeah, it's a very strenuous time because in my case, you know, I've been waiting a couple years to get the nod. So you're sitting in the room, you're like, okay, is this a year? Or am I gonna get, you know, hammered again?
It must feel like a draft day all over again, like sitting and waiting.
No, it's different because you got money this time.
Okay.
Draft, you don't have any cash. It's totally different.
That's true. So I guess that's my question. Because you have money, if you hadn't been inducted, would you have gotten on the next plane out?
Yes.
You would have left.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You wouldn't
and
have stuck
I had,
around.
I had done that the last couple years when I got denied, so I was like, psh, I'm out of here. I'm going to have fun somewhere.
Yeah, there you go. So, obviously, though, that's a special night, and you had your induction ceremony, and here's a photo of you with your bust, and I feel like they did a pretty good job.
They did.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
And
I actually have my Hall of Fame ring.
Where, I can't take that.
No.
I want you to take a look at it.
Because on here, they actually put a bust on the actual ring.
I will say this. This is the only way it would be okay to wear a ring with your face on it. Any other guy who has his face on a ring, know he's bad news.
Right. It's a problem.
So that's good. And that's a beautiful ring. And that is very tastefully done. and now, do you ever wear it?
You know what? I wear it sometimes on television when I'm working at ESPN. It, you know, gives you a little bit of validity in terms of what you say.
Now, is it validity for the people at home, or are you showing off to your colleagues who maybe aren't in the Hall of Fame yet?
No, it's not about...
Be honest.
It's not about showing off.
Do you sort of say, oh, that's it? Are you in or out? I can't remember. And then you use that.
Were you going to believe him or me? No, I don't do
that's good. And, of course, even more excited. Well, I mean, you tell me. I mean, a Hall of Fame's whole career, but, you know, you finished your career in the best possible way. You won a Super Bowl ring your last game.
Yeah.
In your hometown of Detroit. So of your two rings, your Super Bowl ring, your Hall of Fame ring, does one mean more or do they both?
That's a great question. And I get that question a lot, but actually my Super Bowl ring
I
means...
Can't. Jerome, I know.
The Super Bowl ring...
I'm just going to say no. You can finish, but I'm not taking it.
You're not taking it. Okay. This means more to me than the actual Hall of Fame ring because the Hall of Fame ring is really a byproduct of wanting to win a championship because every year, you know, we get, you know, to a championship game, we lose. And so the next year, I rededicate myself. I want to become a better football player, a better person. And so as a result of losing for so many years, wanting to become better, you know, I turn myself from a young running back who didn't know anything into a Hall of Fame running back.
Yeah.
But it was because of this ring.
It was this one. And now, is it true, this one, did you design this ring? You helped design it.
I helped design that ring. And funny story with that. After we won the Super Bowl, obviously, it's in my hometown. I was on the stage. I retired.
Yeah.
The first thing I thought when I got in the locker room is I have to find a way to be on the committee to design the ring because I don't get another shot. I'm done.
Right.
So I saw Mr. Rooney, the owner of the Steelers, and rushed over. I said, Mr. Rooney, I would love to be on the committee to design the ring. And he says, okay, it'll be you and me. And I'm like, I thought it was a committee, right? I'm like, but it sounded great then.
Yeah.
But after all of my teammates found out that I was helping to design it, they came to me and said, listen, it better have ring, it better have diamonds, it better have this, it better, and I'm saying to myself,
yeah,
I'm in trouble.
That's a lot of pressure.
It is, and as it turns out, it was even...
You did a great job.
Yeah, I did a good job.
If my wife had let me help design her engagement ring, I probably would have gone something like this. She didn't want my feedback. She wasn't as nice as Mr. Rooney.
She didn't go for that one.